Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasangan University, India. Today is the fourth lecture of the Fourier transform. Today's topic is discrete time periodic signals, how to transform the discrete time periodic signal. From now, let me explain. Okay, discrete. This means discrete, this means periodic. Discrete time periodic, we can write x of n like this. For example, this is one example, discrete time signal, and this one also. Now you see here, this pattern is repeated here. This pattern is repeated. Therefore, we call this, this is n, 1, 2, 3, 4, the periodical, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is also 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a period n equal 4. Okay. Okay, then frequencies in discrete time periodic signals is, now you can see here, there is no time information. This is no time information here. Therefore, we do not know the frequencies, because we do not have this kind of time information, we don't know. But if we know sampling frequency, then we can know the interval of samples. We call this a sampling period. We call this a TS. Of course, TS equal 1 by sampling frequency. Then now here, this is one period. The time is nts. The frequency means 1 by nts. Also, you can see already 1 by ts is fs. Therefore, this fs by n. This is fundamental frequency. It means correspondence to the f fundamental frequency of 0 in continuous time case. Therefore, fundamental frequency in x of n is omega 0 equal to pi f 0. F 0 is the normalized frequency by sampling frequency, and also f 0 equal this. F 0 means fs by fn. Then from this fs removed, then we can get 2 pi by n. Therefore, the fundamental frequency in discrete time period signal is 2 pi by n. This is a very important concept. And the frequencies, all frequencies in x of n, it means k times of fundamental frequency, k times of w. Therefore, the number of frequencies are infinite frequencies. Okay, we call this, as I said already, this is harmonics. Harmonics. Okay, yes. Okay, let me explain how to know Fourier transform x omega of discrete time period signals, comparing in case of a continuous time case. Okay? From this, we can write this here. Omega is a continuous case. This is a discrete case. Instead of integral, we can use summation over the n equal minus infinity infinite. This is a discrete time signals. And of course, omega equal minus pi to pi. Otherwise, we can use sometime 2 pi also. Now here, in case of a continuous, omega equal minus pi to pi. In case of a discrete case, omega minus pi to pi. Because this is normalized by fs. Okay. Then, how about the discrete time period signals? Now you can see here. In this case, we used, instead of omega, we use k times of omega 0, like this one. This same as instead of omega, we can use k omega 0. Omega 0 equal 2 pi by n, just before previous slide I explained. Also, this is harmonics. Then, we can write from this formula, change the two here. That instead of omega, k omega 0, also omega k omega 0, like this. The summation, the range of summation is 1 period, n equals 0 to n mass. This also, just you integrate the 1 period. Okay, 1 period, we do that. Then finally, we can get Fourier transform of discrete time periodic signals. It is called Fourier transform. Sometimes also we can use now AK, also we can use AK. Also, this is a periodical. Periodical means AK plus N, periodical. This is a periodical. Periodical. This is also very important, one of the properties. Of course, we know A of K, Fourier coefficient, we know we can synthesize the original waveform X of N or this. Also, this is a Fourier series because we use a period signal. Also, they use a period signal. We call this Fourier series. This is not periodic, we say Fourier transform. Okay, this signal is not periodic. Periodic, we call Fourier transform in case of this kind of period signal, we can call Fourier series. Okay, let me take one example how to get A of K from this. X of N equal or this FS equal 6 hertz. Now, already you know this is the one period. Therefore, N equal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Period equal 6. The fundamental frequency equal F by N equal 60 by 6 equal 10 hertz. Therefore, all frequencies 0, 10, 20, 30, and so on. There's no 15, 16, 21, like there's no this. Just a we call this harmonics. Then, AK equal by using the formula, minus AK 2 pi by N, N equal 6 here. Then from this one period, this means so this is 0, 0, that we need to summate N equal 0, 2, or like this is 2. 0, 1, 2. That's 2. Okay, I'm sorry, this is 2. Okay, then we can calculate K equal 0, K equal 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is also called, this is a complex number. From this, we can find, we can calculate the magnitude norm, 3, 2, like this. This means 0 hertz. A1 means 10 hertz, magnitude of 10 hertz. A2 means magnitude of 20 hertz, and so on. Then we can plot this amplitude spectrum. Not spectrum, 10 hertz, amplitude equal 3, the 0 hertz, 10 hertz, amplitude of 10 hertz is 2, and like this. Okay, this is the source code for your reference. Please refer. Thank you so much for your watching. Today, I have explained Fourier transform of a discrete time period signal. You can use a discrete time period signal like this. Then, next topic is a period signal. How to Fourier transform of a period signal. A periodic means this is not periodic signal. Periodic signals. Okay. Please look forward to next lecture. Thank you very much.